Hi, hello, and welcome everybody to Pace Rewind. I'm Tara Bernstein.
And I'm Katie Healy. It's time to rewind into Pace Athletics.
The Setters jumped out to a 12-4 lead in the game's first 7 minutes as Gabriella Rubin and Jacqueline Ostham each drawing triples while Shanice Maynard connected on a pair of jumpers. Now in the second quarter, it's Rubin against converting a three-pointer to put the Setters up by 8. Rubin added 2 more baskets late in the half, but the Setters trailed by a pair at the break. Picking things up in the fourth with Pace trailing by 13, Kirsten Dodge went to work to help bring the Setters back. She scored 6 straight points to cut the lead to just 7 with 6 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the game. She added 7 more points late in the fourth and scored the final 13 points of the game for the Setters, but Pace ultimately fell to the Golden Knights 58-46.
Following the women, the men's basketball team looked to improve to 2-0 in the NE10. The Setters played even with the Golden Knights early in Tuesday's match, leading 6-5 at the 16-24 mark. Later in the first half, Kyle Pearson nailed a 3 to get the Setters back within 4, but the Golden Knights strung together 5 straight points and eventually took the 38-27 lead into halftime. Freshman Ryan Peterson made 4 three-pointers in the second half and matched a season high with 5 in the game, but the Setters were unable to come back, falling 78-65. Pearson scored 15 points and grabbed 8 rebounds in the game, while Shelton McKell tallied 9 points and dished out 6 assists.
After Thanksgiving break, the Setters traveled to Rockville Center, New York to square up against Molloy in a non-conference game. After Dodge opened up the game with consecutive baskets, Maynard took over and made Molloy pay as she splashed 3 deep balls while banking in a layup as well. Pace took a 29-24 lead into the locker room as Ostham scored 8 points in the second quarter. Rubin scored at will in the third, shooting 4-for-4 from the field, including a perfect mark of 2-for-2 from distance while adding a pair of assists. Freshman Chelsea Schultz added 5 points in the quarter, connecting on an early jumper before closing the frame out with the tray during the final Pace possession. Dodge kicked off the fourth with 6 straight Setter points to give Pace a 21-point advantage over the Golden Lions. Freshman Alexandra Monteleone contributed 5 points in the decisive fourth period, connecting on 2 shots, including a 3.
The Pace men's basketball team hosted Concordia College on Sunday at the Goldstein Fitness Center following the Thanksgiving break. The entire starting 5 for the Setters scored in double digits in Sunday's non-conference matchup with the Clippers, led by Victor Jacino's 18. The Setters controlled much of the first half, taking a 30-22 lead with 6 minutes left before the break. Concordia turned it around and went on a 7-1 run to get back within 2. Shelton McKell then drained a 3 to halt the Clippers' run, but Concordia's Peter Aguilar hit one of his own to keep the deficit at 2. With the Setters trailing by 1, Shelton McKell drew a foul with less than 2 seconds before halftime and made both free throws to take a 38-37 lead going into the locker room. Concordia took control in the early goings of the second frame and held a 70-64 lead with just 6:27 remaining. The Setters trailed by 13 in the final minutes of the game and managed to cut the difference to 9 at 81-72 on a jumper by Brian Rivers, but the Clippers never yielded to lead and held on for the 88-79 win. Kyle Pearson turned in a double-double with 14 points and 11 rebounds in the game. Rivers totaled 17 on the game and helped out with 5 assists. Ryan Peterson made 3 more three-pointers and finished with 14 points.
That's a wrap for this week. We'd like to thank everybody involved in Pace Rewind. I'm Tara Bernstein.
And I'm Katie Healy. Thanks for watching. Catch you next week.